Welcome everyone to a new tactics video on my channel. My name is Mark, and in this video I'm going to show you my game plans that I'm using almost all of the time. I'm showing you guys this in my Ultimate Team. I started playing Ultimate Team the week before Christmas, so I'm playing around 3 weeks now, and this is already my team, so I'm really happy with that, of course. If you want to see some content on this channel from Ultimate Team, let me know in the comments if you would like to see that and what kind of content you want to see, so maybe I can make videos about it as well. I'm also going to do online seasons as well, so pretty much a lot of things are going to happen. I'm going to say that, but before I begin, I really wanted to ask you to drop a like under the video. It will be really helpful for me and my channel to grow. My videos will be ranked up higher in YouTube if you all like this stuff, so please drop that like. And if you're new to the channel and want to find your way back really easy, make sure you are subscribed with notifications on. All right, I'm going to show you three tactics, and it's the normal tactic that I'm using from the start. It's an attacking tactic that I like to play when I think my opponent is really weak, or when I needed to score goals. That's when I'm using the attacking formation. And I also have a defensive formation when I think it's needed to be a bit more secure on defense when I'm leading and my opponent is going to try hard to score goals. And it's really hard for me to play the ball around, stuff like that. I'm switching to my defensive formation. So I'm going to show you all three in this video. This is my team. I'm really happy with that. And yeah, we're going to the custom tactics for the first one. And this is the attacking 4-2-3-1 formation. This is the formation that I'm starting with in every game. The formation, it's the 4-2-3-1. Small formation, but Mbappe and Koeman are playing more like wingers. Ben Yedder is my striker. Müller is the attacking midfielder. Tonali is the most defensive midfielder. Goretzka is playing more like a box-to-box player. And we have four defenders that are just staying back, so we are not too weak in the defense. And this is the tactics that I'm using. Defensive style is balanced with a width of 40, a depth of 50. Build up play, balanced, direct passing on chance creation. That's the one that I like the most. The width is 60, plays in the box, 5 bars. Corners and free kicks, both 2 bars for me. Then we're going to the instructions. Let's start with the right defender. All players are on aggressive interceptions. That is what I like at this moment. I think the players are trying harder to get the ball when you have that. And in my opinion, I'm not making lots and lots of falls with this. In the beginning I thought, well, maybe we are getting a lot of free kicks against, but that's not the point. So aggressive interceptions for every player in the squad. Stay back while attacking for all 4 defenders. So also the fullbacks are stay back while attacking. Then we are going to the midfielders. Goretzka, get forward. He has the high attacking work rate, but I really like him to go forward, so I also instruct him to do that. Aggressive interceptions and cover center are the things that I change for him. Tonali is the most defensive midfielder. Cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking, aggressive interceptions and cover center. Then we're going to the right attacking midfielder, that is Koeman. Only thing I change for him is get into the box for the cross and aggressive interceptions. Then we have Müller, the central attacking midfielder. I didn't change anything except the aggressive interceptions, of course. And then we have Mbappe, the same as Koeman, get into the box for the cross and aggressive interceptions. And then my striker, the only thing I changed is get in behind on attacking runs. All right, this is the default formation that I'm playing from the beginning of the match. And then we're going to the attacking formation that I'm using when I needed to score goals, or when I think my opponent is really weak or having a bad moment during the match. Sometimes you have that opponent is beginning really, really good and you think, oh my gosh, this guy is really good. And then during the match, you feel, well, he's not that good at all. He is losing lots of possession or whatever, and I need to score a goal right now. And then we can go to this formation. It's the 4-3-3 attacking formation. It's a formation that I always liked, because you have 2 wingers, you have a striker, you have an attacking midfielder. So really, really attacking formation. What I do is defensive style press after possession loss with a width of 50 and a depth of 60. So we're playing some pressure football, build up plays, fast build up, chance creation, forward runs. The width 60, plays in the box 6 bars, corners and free kicks 3 bars. Then going to the instructions of the players, let's start with the right defender again. I do stay back while attacking for all four defenders, because else, especially with the fast build-up, these guys will more play like wingers than like defenders. They are going too high on the pitch, in my opinion, especially with goal kicks or free kicks, or when you just want to pass the ball around a bit. They are so high up on the field. It's not the way that I like to play. So stay back while attacking, and everybody on aggressive interceptions as well. Two center backs are default, and then we have Hernandez, the same. Stay back while attacking and aggressive interceptions. Then we're going to Goretzka, get forward, aggressive interceptions, and cover center. Then we have Tonali, stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross, aggressive interceptions, and cover center. Then we're going to Müller. Only thing I changed for him is free roam and aggressive interceptions. Then to the right side, Coman, cut inside, get in behind, get into the box for the cross and aggressive interceptions. Then we have Ben Jedder. Only thing I changed is getting behind and the aggressive interceptions. And Mbappe, cut inside, get in behind, get into the box for the cross and aggressive interceptions. All right, then we're going to my most defensive tactics that I'm using when I'm leading and I think my opponent is better trying to score a goal. Then I'm switching to this one, or when I just want to pass the ball around and yeah, don't want to attack that hard, then I also can use this formation as well. The formation is the 4-3-3 holding formation, so you're playing with two central midfielders and a central defensive midfielder. And the tactics that I'm using is defensive style drop back. So when I lose the ball, I want everybody to come back as soon as possible, because we want to keep that lead, or yeah, I want just a bit secure in my defense. So that's why I'm using the drop back. The width is 50, the depth 49, but that must be 50 as well. Doesn't matter that much. Build up play, slow build up, and chance creation on possession. So we're passing the ball around really secure. Make sure that when you are passing, that you be 99 or 100% sure that the pass is going to be completed. No risk at all, just pass the ball around. Be patient, and yeah, you can also score, create chances to score goals this way. So then we're going to the width, that is 50. Plays in the box, 4 bars, corners and free kicks, both 2 bars. Then we're going to the instructions. Let's start with the right defender again. Balanced attack. And what I want to say is I didn't change anything in all these players. I tried it out. I switched some things, but every player is default. Let's go back to the instructions, sorry. As you can see, everybody is just default. And why is that? It is because of the slow buildup. It is because of the possession. And if you want to play some possession football, you don't want to instruct your players too much, because they need to do what they need to do to keep the ball in your squad. At your own players, don't lose the ball. So sometimes they need to make runs, sometimes they need to come to the ball, to the man that has the ball. So if you leave everything to default, in my opinion, that is the best way. So the players, let the AI do the work. 80% of the time the player is doing the right things, not all the time, because the AI is not perfect, we all know that. But if you keep in mind that you just want to play the ball around, there's always 1, 2, or 3 options to play the ball around. So be secure at your passing, look around, take a total overview over the field, and decide yourself what is the best to do. So pass the ball around and wait for the right opportunity to create your chance and score the goal. So try it out yourself with this. Every thing on default and let me know in the comments what you think of it or if you would change something. All right, this is it. You can also use this in online seasons, especially with the five-star teams. You can use all these three formations as well. So if you're looking for good game plans in online seasons, try this out and hopefully you will win with this and get your benefits out of this. This is the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and don't forget to comment what you like to see on this channel. It's really worthwhile for me if you will do that. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.